Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Drakensang. In today's episode, we are going to see about kind of working towards getting out of Avonstrew. What we're going to do immediately is go take care of the bandit problem. I think we should be able to handle that, and when doing so, we will get another party member, I think. I believe we'll pick up a rogue. After that, we're probably going to deal with the bear, and once we've dealt with the bear, we might deal with the wolves. I don't know if we're going to be able to deal with the wolves, because it's a very difficult fight, and I don't know if we'd be able to get it without a pretty solid melee presence in the party, because I don't think our Amazon companion would be able to solo all the wolves while I sit back and throw spells. Anyways, switch back to me here. Ah, Devon, the power. Alright, and I believe we want to go up this way. See, here's the message log. I knew it was around here somewhere. This really isn't much use unless it's really not much use unless you're into the really particulars, because it'll like give you two hit rolls and stuff.
I got you the diadem. Now give me your word of honor that you won't do anything to Selena.
The diadem. Good. Very good. Fex must indeed favor your lover. She is of no further interest to me, now that I have the diadem. Such a shame that your god is not here to protect you. Kill him.
Little scaly McLizard face over there is a nice jerk. See you. Throw her into aggressive mode, have her pull her sword, and wait in. And I really probably shouldn't be up in the melee like this, but I'm gonna do it anyways. Excuse me. Devon's like, I'm all ineffectual and everything. Ow. Got a little combat. Yeah, what now? Aw, man. Oh, that was a good one. I don't think I'm gonna be able to cast before he's dead yet.
They almost sent me to Boron.
Indeed, you must be Dranor. Selena is looking for you everywhere. Selena, oh, by Raja and Fex, I have to return or she will curse my name. I must return to her. Go to Selena. Hurry, I'm sure she misses you. May Raja be with you. It's looting time. Alright, some far things and a knife. We got robber emblems, which I believe all they are is for selling stuff. Let's see. Run. And we have a chest over here that I don't think we're going to be able to get into because it's locked. Darn it. Is there anything else? A barrel. Nature's most deadly foe. Some bandages. Okay. Basically, this chest, what we're going to do is come back. Once he joins our party, we should be able to back here, and all will be well again. Come along, minion. There's more barrels and stuff over there, but I don't believe they have anything worthwhile in them, so we're not gonna bother running all the way out there to smash them. And I think... Yes, she gained a level. What leveling does, you get more vitality, more aether if you've got it, and some more endurance. Also, it increases the caps of your skills. So, like, she can pump this up another level. She could put her treat wounds higher, and so on. Now, but we're going to level up her other stuff here. Think. Well, what here? Characters of survival, less quickly the bearings in the wilderness. Rare plants and useful animals. Okay. And human nature. Yeah. We'll give her another one in Animal Lore. Okay, and Devon Has sabers maxed. Can't really do anything else there. So we'll throw up, I think, his arcane lore. What's my magic hall? Identify potions, artifacts. Okay. So we're going to want to crank that up as well. And with his remaining points, throw him into human nature. Devon is a charming fellow. Oh. Also, I did some reading. Which one was it? I think this one. Alright, the SP, that's the spell level you're casting at. So, like, I've got this at 1, so that's the modifier on it. So, at 0, it wouldn't really do anything. Okay, so next up, we're actually probably going to meander our way towards town. Come on. We're going to meander our way towards town so we can recruit that thief. Yeah, eat fiery death. Oh crap, oh crap, oh crap. Ah! These things will, like, maim you if you're not careful. Ah, crap, yeah. That's what I was trying to avoid. Get on the... There we go. Fiery death! Yeah! Also some lightning! Yeah! I'm gonna stab you in the face. Alright, go Devon. Oh, we got a wound. Okay, we are wounded. This is why we have a ton of band-aids. Basically, wounds, like, drop your combat attributes and stuff. They're a huge pain in the ass. So you want to get rid of them as quickly as possible. Ah, Devon. Why you no bandage good? Come on, bro. There we go. And as you can see, his wound is gone, and he's now got the restoration buff on him. And towards town, and I think we earned a... Before we go...
Good choice.
You... Face this way, there we go. Might as well have her loot the bodies and do any gathering off of them.
For Amazon Pride.
The crafting comes in handy later. I'm actually probably going to give her fletching. Once we've got some more money to us, so that she can make her own arrows for her bow and stuff. And there's a weapon upgrade system and stuff. Like, you can make, like, a basic bow, and then to make the next bow tier up, you need a basic bow and other things.
Here we go.
Okay. Don't know how much we're going to be doing with the upgrade system, like, for crafting and stuff. I really don't know how much crafting we're going to be doing. But I'll probably pick up the basic skills just so I've got them. And, like, if we happen to have ingredients, we might as well type thing. And I love the map for this game. Let's see if I can get the, like, area map. No, this is all we got. Oh, there we go. Like, I love how it's all hand-drawn and everything. It's so awesome. And to give you guys a bit of scope here, we are, I think, here. Next, we'll be coming up this way, and this is all the area we have to explore here. So it's not exactly a tiny game. Excuse me. And yes, before anyone asks, I will probably be doing River of Time. I've been eyeing it on, like, Steam, just waiting for it to go on sale. I don't know if I'm going to do it immediately after this one. I'm probably not going to, but it will be done eventually. Oh my god, those deer are mad. Hey, guardsman, kneeling. You took care of your bandit problem. Let's see here. I think that's how we want her. We want to keep her on offensive. The only downside is that when they're on offensive mode, well, aggressive, they will, like, go out of their way to attack things and you can get in trouble. But the worst thing that'll happen then is I'll get fed up with it and I'll probably throw her into defensive and then combat will be a pause fest. Which I actually apologize for, because I tend to pause the game a lot while fights are going on. You should see me playing, like, Baldur's Gate. It's a nightmare. I swear I spend more time paused than actually in real time.
How dare you try and make a living, young man? If I were younger, I'd smack you in the face.
Crazy old bag. Mountebank Queen. And then we have a laboratory, which I believe that's... that crazy woman.
Now who do we have here? The prodigal son has returned.
Selena, my angel. Let me explain what happened.
What is there to explain? Give me back my heirloom. You know how much it means to me.
He doesn't have it anymore, right? The fox sold it for some quick coin.
Yes, I don't have it anymore. But I didn't sell it. The stranger, he took it.
Oh, yeah. And did the stranger just happen to let a bag of ducats drop for it?
Selena, please believe me. I only did it for us.
Whatever, Draenor. You've disappointed me. It's going to take time for me to trust you again. So go, please. But I thank you for rescuing Draenor. As a token of my gratitude, I will intercede with Nandor for you. If your word isn't good enough for him, tell him I'll spill the beans about what he did on the first Praeus Day last year.
Okay, now let us talk to Draenor.
That scoundrel certainly wouldn't have gotten off so lightly if he'd stolen something from me.
That's why you're badass, Amazon lady.
Well, well, how can good old Draenor help you out of trouble?
Come with me, Draenor. New adventures await us. And now we have a thiefy guy. I think he's actually a thief, too. A rogue. Alright, what kind of specialities he's got? He's a fencer. Alright, and he has throwing knives. Feint, master parry, and aim throw. Alright, so his EP and throwing knives. And he has some hairpins, which we will pass him more. Okay. And I'm gonna probably pick up more bandages so that each of them can have a stack of them going. And we're gonna hold on to this axe too, because there's a character we get later and that we're gonna want to give it to. And I believe the max party size in this is 4. Let's see, 1, 2, chick, yeah, 4. Okay, and we're gonna want to get his abilities down there. Master parry. Feint and aimed throw. Alright, let's go. First stop, the church. Because there's a chest there that I want to try picking. Actually, does he have any experience points? No. How is his lock picking at? Pick locks. Alright, 6, not bad. Well, hello. Oh.
At your service.
Draenor, I have a task for you. Hairpins. Nope. Gotta use the hairpins to do it. You can do it without hairpins, but you take a penalty to the, like, roll to do it, and if you fail it, then you take, like, a temporary penalty for a long time. It's like, it's not a long time, it's like 30 seconds, but it makes picking locks more or less impossible. Alright, come on, guys. You can actually duel these mercenaries, but I've never been able to beat them. Although I think it's only there's only one you have to beat, but they're very tough. Rito Bento, the merchant. Wandering up ahead. And I think now we are going to go for that bear. Get that out of the way. After looting the church. Come on, guys. Why do you hang back so much? You actually, I might be able to tell them to stick closer to me. And if I can, then I shall. Nope. Lockpicks. As Divine comes up and just beats him in the head with the back of his saber. Oh, lockpick failed, and now he's got shaky hands. And we must wait. Come on. There we go. Let's try this again. Could be in a fail boat, Draenor. Go. A note. Avis Shrine. Let's see, I think we have a section of... Yes. What's the difference? Okay. Okay. It's not backwards. No clue. Maybe the priest can tell us something.
What can I do for you?
What do you have for sale? Haha, bandages. Okay, first we want to sell some stuff here. We're gonna off these, this, and we'll hold on to the one berry because I believe you can use those to make healing potions.
I'll take care of that.
Let's see, get rid of these. Get rid of that. Hold on to those. Hold on to all of that. Okay. So we're sitting at 3 ducats. So I have 27. She's got. We're gonna get them each 20, I think. And that should be more than enough for a good while. Typically, I buy stacks of 100 and then just divvy them up, but I'm trying to kind of hoard money because. Once we get out of this area, we actually get access to good shops, and they have all kinds of nifty stuff to buy. And it's all very expensive, of course. Come on, guys. Oh, that's right. I wanted to see about making them move closer. What's she on about now, those stupid wolves? Shut up, you old bag! Talk.
Well, how could good old...
No. Damn. You can, like, bug them about their past and stuff, but this early on, they won't tell us anything of interest. Let me think. I think if we're nice to this guy, he'll give us some wood, which we want. We can use that for making arrows. Woodcutter Nebula, the man is a bear.
Hey there, what's up?
Human nature from Dranor, actually. Oh. Isn't cutting wood all day hard work? You must have the muscles of a bear. Well, naturally. After all, I come from a family of woodsmen. Would you like some of this elm wood? It's good for whittling fine figures. Of course it takes some practice. I would love to have some wood, thank you. Sweet. And he gave us 2 logs of elm wood. Cool. And I think it's like 1 elm wood, some arrowheads and feathers, and you'd like make 10 or 20 arrows. So, and she needs ammo. And Dranor's SOL because I have no idea what the recipe for throwing knives would be. Okie dokie dokie doke. Come on, you guys. And you actually have multiple little quick slot bars. Which. There's actually a way to navigate through. I think you hold on like, no, it's not control. I don't know what it is. Damn it. But you can navigate through them, and if you get quick with it, it's pretty decent. But I try to stick to one bar per character just for simplicity's sake. However, like I said in episode 1, I've not played very far into this, so we might need to use multiple bars. And if that's the case, there will be navigation going on. I can definitely see multiple bars for Devon because he's a spellcaster. Now we have a boar up here, yes. Where is it? I see it. She's going to arrow it, and Devon is going to fireball it.
Well,
and he's going to be all kinds of useless and be like, I'm a rogue, fear me! And Devon's like, oh crap. Wasting arrows, you fool.
Drink blood, my sword!
Fiery death! Oh god! Leave Devon alone! Let's see. He's only got 31 hit points. Yeah! I really should be buffing him with like his spells, but lazy! They're handling well enough. I think I'm gonna bring Dranor over here to help. She's more than capable of killing, like, everything. And of course, Devon has picked up a wound. Ooh, so is he. Dranor, you fool! Oh, no lightning-y death. Okay. Dranor.
Listen up, everyone.
Gonna stack her bandages here real quick. I wonder what his treat wounds is. Terrible, of course. Alright, her and Devon are both pretty good, so
I'll take care of that.
We'll have her mend his wound. It would be nice if we could succeed here, Devon. I don't want to. God dang it. There we go. No, you don't have to do that. Harvest! Yeah, damn it. Take this pelt scraps. And got the second thing while we're at it. Take the other pelt scraps. And a wild boar skin. Okay. Come on, guys. Let's do this thing. Come on, guys. Thank you. See your message left. So as you see, it gives you a lot of information, which is actually pretty nice. They seem to simulate the actual game pretty damn well. And of course, looking at this is like Latin to me right now. I'm sure we'll eventually pick up like how you do things. I know it's based on like a success rolls type thing, like you roll so many dice and you have to get so many successes to do something. But yeah, I don't know much about it beyond that. I really should probably flip through the manual and read it in earnest again. Alright, now as you can see, since we're in like an adventure site now, like indoors, they stick really close, and the reason for that is because the pathing AI is terrible. And if it's saving, I'm going to save. This door, actually, right here is a nightmare of getting out of. Because what'll happen is they'll be following you. Damn it. Camera, stop! They'll be following you back and they'll get caught up in here and just like run endlessly at it like that. And it's a nightmare and horrible. The wizard's going to be trouble. And we're going this way because this leads us to the wizard. The other way leads to the bear. And we want the wizard with us because he will make the fight, you know, winnable. Alright, I'm actually going to do some spells here. First, we have some light. Oh, and we have a trap. No use. God dang it. You stupid God almighty. Alright, we're going to see what we can do here with spells. Skin of Steel increases natural armor for 5 minutes. How long do these last? 5 minutes. 5 minutes. And that's a debuff. We don't care. Alright, so we're doing Fastness of Body, definitely, because that's like protective magic. And it's going to be either Agility or Dexterity, depending on which effects. Examine. Writing during disarming traps. Alright, compare that to agility. Good at jumping. Quick actions. Alright, so agility and fastness of body and attributal agility. And do it on yourself. Might as well share the buff, love. Okay, we give her agility, so that means he gets dexterity. While Devon's casting, she can mend her wound from the trap. What does she get? No clue. And our light spell's gonna wear off. We don't really need it, but I just think it's kind of a nifty little effect. Alright, come on, you two idiots. Oh my god. I know there's, like, things in here, so I'd really rather not get caught on my own. Alright, we got a monster somewhere to the right of us. Oh, wow. We have wolf rats. Where's the rest of the party? I don't know, but Devon can solo this. He's like, I've got this. Alright, not too bad. We handled them fairly well.
Will do.
Get its tail. And those are what, 14 experience? Oh, level adjustment, because they're higher level. Oh, he only got one. Okay. Well, hell, if they're... What level is, Draenor? Oh, he's third level, dang. And we're just gonna
Listen up, everyone.
Light wax here. Yes, harvest. Failure. God damn it. Okay. There's some... Strange. It'd be easier to hear if you guys weren't following me for like a mile away. And we have strange looking rocks. Stone does seem to have something magical about it, though, as if containing a living creature. Okay. Oh, Draenor! We have loot in a box. Alright, what do we got here? Some money, a knife, a wolfskin, and a club. Fell barrels, rusty nails and pelt scraps, and a hairpin. Cool. Alright. Carrying on. Ow. Ooh, got some accumulated wounds from that one. Bring her up and have her heal him. Alright, he's good. You don't have to worry about it. There we go. I should really probably let Draenor lead in here, but... Well, I'm squishier than he is. I don't know. I think the wizard's up here. Yep. What are you doing? Hey, another chest. God dang it! Devon's like, ooh, loot! And then he gets exploded by a fireball trap or something. Archmage Rakorium. But only after looting. Okay, come on, open the chest. Oh, it was trapped too, dang. Okay, so we got some money, leather arm greaves, a cub, and a wolfskin. Alright. So he's wearing gloves, so these are more or less the same. What is she? Leather arm greaves, leather arm greaves. What about him? He's got gloves on. Well, at this point, what is more stylish for Devon? I'm thinking the gloves work for him. Okay. Oh, Archmage!
What? Are you creeping up on me like a Meristanian or a devil cat or something?
He's gone mad! Excuse me, I'm Devon of Echelon. Are you Master Rakorium?
Yes, boy, that's me. These paintings, I would... Well then, boy, what do you want from me?
You seem a little confused, Master Rakorium. I was sent here to find you. Won't you come outside with me? Your apprentices Rufus and Noddle are worried about you. They said that you could help me get to Furdock. I need two respectable citizens who will vouch for my good character.
Where are those two useless... I mean, where are my apprentices exactly? We were at the inn and then they suddenly disappeared. At least you're still here, Noddle.
I am not your student Noddle, Master Rakorium. My name is Devon of Echelon.
What? That's a very nice name. Of course you're on my apprentice. You know when I was young... Oh, what was her name again?
Let's go now. I shall lead you out of the caves.
Ah, yes. Time flies, doesn't it? I have to reach Furdock before sundown. Shall we go, then? Once we get back to the village, I shall write you a letter of recommendation for the toll station. The two of us will stick together no matter how many bridges those scaly beasts accompany, won't we?
What are all those strange boulders hereabouts? Are you somehow responsible for them?
I'm afraid that was the my doing. They were disciples of the lizards and the dragons, but I fear my spell... They may wake up soon. But what was that other spell I was thinking of?
Then we should leave at once. And now, he's a guest. That's what the white border means. As you can tell, we can't, set him to offensive or defensive, and he will more or less do whatever he wants. He's got 23 vitality, 15 endurance, and 4,000 astral energy. That's just because he spams magic. And unlike the rest of the party, he follows close because he's a smart old man.
Stop doing your magic. Otherwise it'll...
What?
Sneak up on him.
Where's that old hermit gone now?
Yes. Fiery death. Oh. Hey, get off of the squishy. Woman, get him off of him. Uh-oh. Oh. He has this... I think that's his crazy lightning... Yeah. Oh, that didn't do as much as I know it does. He's got this one that, like, just wastes everything.
I'll take care of that.
Alright, let's see. She can do that. And you... What does... I don't even know what Master Parry does, but we're going to employ it. Is it just a toggle then? Alright. Oh! Damn, there you go. I shall employ Magical Zest! Eventually. Oh, or not. I just look good in the background. That's Devon's job, just looking good in the background. Of course she failed. Got some wound powder, though.
Listen up, everyone.
Try this again. And I'd heal him, but he should be okay. Come on, guys. Okay, he's good. And I know that we are over half an hour, so I shall save. And okay. And so we're gonna call it. So, thanks for watching, folks, and I will see you next time, wherein we shall face a bear and get out of the little tutorial city here. So until then, folks.